Hi, my name is Yunzhu. Today, we are presenting to you our recent work on visual grounding of NERD physical models. This work is done in collaboration with Toru, Kexin, Dan Baer, Dan Yamins, Jiajun, George Tenenbaum, and Antonio Torralba. Understanding the physical properties of interacting objects has been a long-standing goal in computer vision, robotics, and artificial intelligence. As humans, by merely watching objects interact, we are able to distinguish between different object instances, reason about their physical properties, and make predictions on their future movements. More impressively, this ability applies to not only rigid bodies, but also deformable objects, such as elastic materials and fluids. Given the example shown in the videos, humans can automatically identify the separation between liquid and solid, estimate their physical properties, such as viscosity, stiffness, and gravity. We can also predict key features of their future motion through mental simulation. Let me give you an intuitive example. Different physical parameters can lead to drastically different behaviors, like the softer rope will be more bouncy. The boxes will fall faster if the gravity is larger. Humans can estimate the physical parameters and predict the future using the intuitive physics engine in our brain. If the prediction does not match the observation, we can correct our estimation by minimizing the discrepancy between our mental simulation and the actual observation. For computational systems, physical reasoning on interacting deformable objects has been a highly challenging task due to the diverse dynamical characteristics of different materials and their interactions. Take fluid as an example. Fluids can deform, separate, merge, and oscillate into arbitrary shapes, and some are hard to perceive due to their transparent nature. In this work, we employ a particle-based intermediate representation for representing objects of different materials due to its generalization ability and flexibility. We propose a model that jointly estimates their physical properties and refines the particle locations using a learned visual prior and a dynamics prior. Our model, named Visually Grounded Physics Learner, VGPL, takes a sequence of image frames as input, reasons about the underlying physical properties, and makes future predictions. The input frame first goes through the perception module, also known as the visual prior, which reconstructs the input thing in particle representation by giving a proposal on particle positions and instance segmentation. An inference module operates on those particles, predicting and refining estimates of particle locations and their physical parameters, subject to the constraints imposed by the dynamics prior, which we refer to as visual grounding. The dynamics module takes in outputs from the inference module and predicts particle positions into the future. We evaluate our model in environments involving interactions between rigid objects, elastic materials, and fluids. Within a few observation steps, our model is able to perform a dynamics-guided inference to refine the state estimation and reason about the physical properties, which allows us to make predictions into the future. Next, I will first discuss the related work and then go through the details of our model and the experimental results. Learning-based particle dynamics has recently gained attention in physical reasoning and control. Particles provide a dense and flexible representation that is well-suited for representing objects with diverse materials and dynamical properties. Particles also facilitate relational inductive bias for more generalizable dynamics modeling. Still, it remains a question that how well they can handle raw visual inputs and adapt to environments of unknown physical properties. Inference and visual grounding of the essential physical properties remains a challenging research problem. Other people have tried differentiating through physics-based simulators to extract gradients. which showed strong results in solving inverse problems of various physical environments. However, they usually make strong assumptions on the structure of the system, and their optimization process for dealing with the inverse problems is usually both time-consuming and prone to local optima. Also, most of them directly operate on the state information of the dynamical system, lacking a way of handling raw visual inputs. Our work aims to bridge the perception gap, enable physical reasoning from visual perception, and perform dynamics-guided inference to directly predict the optimization results, which will allow us to quickly adapt to environments of unknown physical properties. To formulate the problem, consider a system that contains m objects and n particles. Given the visual observation O, our model first uses a learned visual prior, FV, to obtain a proposal of the particle position, x hat, and the grouping information, g hat, for each particle, indicating the instance it belongs to. Our model also incorporates a learned dynamics prior, FD, that predicts future states based on the history of particle positions and physical properties of the system. These properties, including the rigidness of each object instance, q hat, and the environmental physical parameters, p hat. The reason for modeling the rigidness of the objects is because all particles belonging to a rigid object are subject to rigid motion, whereas we do not impose any constraints if a particle belongs to a deformable object. Both p and q are inferred by an inference module fi, which also generates an offset delta x hat to refine the proposed particle locations, such that the dynamics model can explain the observation and predict the particle trajectories into the future. Our inference module fi is tuned to minimize the following objective, which subjects to the constraints induced by the fixed visual and dynamics priors, fv and fd. Next, I will go through the details of each module. The visual prior, fv, takes in a sequence of visual observation images, O, and then predicts the position of the particles and the probability distribution over all object instances that the particle might belong to. The visual prior is trained on the ground truth particle states acquired from the physics engine. The full loss function is written as here, where H stands for the coarse entropy loss. Here, we show some qualitative results of our visual prior in environments involving interactions between fluids and rigid objects, a ball hanging on a rope, and rigid cubes falling down and colliding with each other. As for the dynamics prior, the positions of the particles x define a point cloud that indicates the spatial span of the objects in the environment. The particles form groups G to represent different object instances. each particle has a binary rigidity label Q that indicates whether the object it belongs to is a rigid body. Rigid objects will be constrained to only exert rigid motion. Finally, the environment also has a set of real-valued physical parameters P, like viscosity, gravity, stiffness, etc. Specifically, we use a dynamic particle interaction network, DPINet, to perform dynamical updates on the particle states using graph neural networks and spatial message passing. Here, we show some qualitative results of our dynamics prior in various environments. The key step of grounding a learned dynamics model to visual inputs is to infer the physical properties underlying the visual observed system. In our case, the rigidness of the objects Q and the environmental physical parameters P. We apply an inference module FI to predict these properties from the observed particle proposals generated by the visual prior. The module also outputs refinements on the particle's positions delta x hat, the inference module FI is also a variant of graph neural networks that aggregates both spatial and temporal information. Please refer to our paper for more details of the model. Next, we will present the experimental results in the following three environments, where we aim to investigate how accurate the following estimations are and whether they help with future prediction: rigidness estimation, parameter estimation, and position refinement. We first show the results on predicting the particle positions after 20 time steps. Here, we compare the ground truth with the results of our model together with a version without rigidness estimation. From the video, we can see that without proper estimation of the rigidness, the rigid cube melts into the fluid. In the box falling environment, the rigid cubes will scatter or distorted. Here we show the quantitative results of our model's performance on estimating the rigidness in the rope environment and the fluid environment. The inference module was trained on inputs with only 10 time steps, shown here using orange dashed line. But the model can extrapolate to both shorter and longer input sequences. Longer observation sequence leads to higher accuracy, which is in line with our intuition. Next, we show the results on parameter estimation. Again, the video shows the result on predicted particle positions into the future by comparing the ground truth with the results of our model, together with a version without parameter estimation. As can be seen from the video, if the model does not properly estimate the physical parameters, the cubes either fall too fast or too slow. The rope either contracts too much or too little. Here, we compare our model with dense fixed nets and another model whose dynamics prior does not impose any constraints for rigid body motion. We measure the performance using the mean absolute error between each module's prediction and the ground truth. Numbers in parentheses report the standard deviation. The third part is the performance on position refinements. The videos show the qualitative results on predicting the future with and without the position refinements. Without position refinements, the cube is distorted. Or in the rope environment, the particles scattered around. In the fluid environment, the particles is in a more irregular shape than our prediction. Here, we show our model's performance on the position refinement task by comparing particle position proposed by the visual prior, shown using the blue bar, and after the refinement using our inference module, shown as the orange bars. We use the mean squared error between the ground truth and the predicted positions as the evaluation metric. In all environments, the mean squared error decreases after refinement. Finally, we show the mean squared error between the future prediction of the particle positions and the ground truth on all environments, as shown in the table. With better and more thorough estimation of the physical properties, we can predict the future positions more accurately, especially when making long-term predictions. In summary, we proposed visually grounded physics learner, VGPL, to simultaneously reason about physics and make future predictions based on visual and dynamics priors. We employ a particle-based representation to handle both rigid bodies, deformable objects, and fluid. Experiments show that our model can infer the physical properties within a few observation steps, which allows the model to quickly adapt to unseen scenarios and make accurate predictions into the future. Thank you for watching.